Well, a fourth-generation British company that's all for making home-cut French fries is setting up on Prince Edward Island. Hopkins UK was enticed to come here by a Charlottetown restaurant owner, Hamid Sanoy, who moved to the island about 8 years ago, and he was astounded so many eating establishments on PEI were serving frozen fries. Island Morning's Laura Chapin dropped by Hopkins PEI's new manufacturing location in the West Royalty Industrial Park to learn more. Good morning, Laura.
Good morning, Matt. Yeah, Hopkins UK is based in Leeds. It sells a machine that cuts French fries quickly. They've also created a high-efficiency fryer. Four people, including a welder, have already been hired to work at Hopkins PEI's manufacturing facility in the industrial park. CEO Chris Hopkins expects they'll start producing chip-cutting machines in a couple of weeks there. The hope is eventually 20 people will work at Hopkins PEI, and if the company achieves that target, it'll get almost $200,000 in an ECOA and labor, rent, and marketing subsidies from the province. Chris Hopkins started by showing me how the chip cutter works.
The potatoes are loaded into the hopper here. They drop through the centre there. The potatoes are turned to maximise the length of the potato, so you've got the longest fry possible. The potato is then forced around that edge and then through these cutting blades and straight out. Nice, simple machine. Very easy to keep clean. You just take it apart, hose it down, and reassemble it again. We've been making this type of equipment for the last, well, more than 50 years. It goes throughout the world. Hamid here, again, has used the equipment back in the UK. When he came to Canada and opened his restaurant, he found there were people still chipping by hand, using one potato at a time. He couldn't understand what they were doing. We supplied him with some equipment, and from there it sort of snowballed. And now we're wanting to start manufacturing here. Just set on a welder yesterday. There's more equipment coming. So we're wanting to actually manufacture here on the PEI. Got two types of fry cutter. One is like a rotary one, comes in different sort of sizes. But we can also do a different type that produces the crinkle cut chips. We've also got a high efficiency fryer, which we're in the process of getting approval for. So it's coming on nicely.
And I know you've got 75 people working in England?
Yes, right. Back in the UK, yes. Yeah.
What do you think the workforce will be here? What size?
Well, at the moment, we're up to five if you get a bit part-time. Again, we're wanting to expand. I would imagine somewhere in the region of about 20 by the time we're finished.
And why PEI?
Well, mainly because Hamid sort of semi-started and got the ball rolling. Innovations PEI have been very helpful in helping us get the company up and started. They've been very, very helpful.
You're renting this space from the PEI government?
That's right, yeah.
Would you have come to PEI if you didn't get the financial help?
No, I don't think so.
The market in North America, I'd heard it was 8 times what you've had in the UK?
Yes, well, in the UK, these products have been around for 75, 80 years, and virtually every person that produces fries uses a fry cutter. And I'm quite amazed that in North America and the rest of it, they've just not developed it. People just doing it by hand. It's so labour intensive. The advantages of these machines, they produce it much, much quicker, much more reliable.
How much time do you think you're saving?
The savings are huge because they freeze up the staff. It's not trying to do staff out of a job. It just stops the really boring, labour-intensive job that it is.
How much does a cutter cost?
You're looking about $5,500, maybe $6,000, which sounds a lot, but it will save a lot in time and the saving you can have on over the frozen fries.
Given that we have been doing it by hand for so long, how tough do you think it will be to convince people to switch?
Quite easy. We put one into a chain and they've rolled it throughout the franchise. They're going literally all over. We went out to Las Vegas yesterday. So they are going out quite nicely.
That is CEO Chris Hopkins. He says cutting fries with a Hopkins machine is about 20 times faster than doing it by hand. Mm. And the Gahan Pub and the Old Dublin here in Charlottetown are already using fry cutters from them.
You said, Laura, that this all started with Hamid Sanoy, who owns Water Street Fish and Chips here in Charlottetown. Did you get to meet him?
Yeah, I did. Hamid Sanoy is originally from Iran, but he moved to PEI from England 8 years ago, and that is how he knew about this chip cutting machine.
When we moved here 8 years ago with my family, the first restaurant I opened and realized, you know, the everybody in best place for a potato using the frozen French fries. So I was surprised to see that. And I know the taste of the fresh French fries is totally different with the frozen one. So I bought one of these machines from UK and imported here to start using it in my restaurant. And a couple of years ago, when I went back to see the family and friend back UK, and I went to see Chris, and I told him about the opportunity for the machine in North America, because apparently nobody's seen this machine and didn't know, you know, this machine exists. That's why they're still using the hand-cutting machine.
Hamid Sanoy, he runs Water Street Fish and Chips in Charlottetown. He's originally from Iran and moved to PEI 8 years ago. He's now on the board of directors for Hopkins PEI and is also an investor. And I know there's no operation happening right now. They're just getting up and started, mm-hmm. but Compass plans to head in and do some shooting so that people can see what this is all about coming up in a couple weeks.
All right, so we'll see that soon on CBC Television's Compass. It is 20 minutes now past 7 o'clock here on Island Morning.